Yes, well, that's what makes you such an interesting fellow, Mr. Irish. Ah, Mr. Marston, I've come to wish you well. How are you, sir?
I'm okay.
It seems that our friend Mr. Irish here is well connected south of the border.
Oh, it's true. They love me down there. It's like a second home. I've got more friends than you could shake a stick at, should you so desire.
So you know the way?
Oh, it's easy. We just get on me raft here and let the current sweep us away to paradise. Come on then, Dobby.
I'm not sure your idea of paradise and mine are quite the same, Irish.
Relax. We'll have a great time and we'll find your man Williamson, no bother.
I hope so.
Hey, come on now. Look at it this way. I know we ain't exactly old pals, but, you know, have I ever done you wrong?
No, but not through lack of trying.
Hey!
Well, you boys have fun down there. I shall miss you, John Marston.
Thank you. Where are you headed?
London or Paris or maybe Peking. I'm a traveling man, sir. This land is much too small for the likes of me.
Well, try not to get yourself killed.
Oh, well, yes, we men of science are not a very loved bunch in this land of myth and superstition. I'm off to the civilized world, where men like myself are revered and given medals.
Ha!
Have fun.
The same to you, sir. The same to you.
Nice of you to turn up for once, Irish.
What do you mean?
In usual fashion, you conveniently missed all the action at Fort Mercer.
What can I say? I woke up with me head in a pair of tits, and it felt ill-mannered not to get reacquainted with him.
At least you got your priorities straight.
You know me, Johnny boy. I'll be late to me own funeral. They say God invented whiskey to stop the Irish from ruling the world.
Well, we're here now.
Shite, somebody doesn't like us.
Cut the rope, Irish. We're sitting ducks here.
Hello?
We'll ride the river out. We'll put trying to land till we're well away from these battles. But just some ammunition near the back of the raft. Grab it if you're running low.
You ain't getting another penny out of me.
I see ya.
Johnny Nara!
Shite up. Welcome to Mexico, Johnny boy. Makes Austin look like Buckingham Palace. Sakes alive! There's the idiot.
These fellas.
I suppose it was something to do with the money. Please don't misunderstand me.
you got some pickers to be stuck in! I came into this wild fighting, and I'll go out of it fighting.
I expect you'll go out of it pissed in your pants.
I'm riding you! Stand your head down! Shite! There's more fools behind that rock!
Get the hell away from me!
I haven't stepped foot in this country and they're already trying to kill me!
Well, you will insist on fraternizing with a notorious Irish outlaw.
You tell me. You must have been called it a few times.
On the cliff to your left. More of the bastards. Johnny boy, I really will.
I doubt you'll remember any of it, Irish.
There's a beach coming up on the left. Hang on, we'll be on dry land soon. Heads up, there's two more! We made it, thank the Lord. Am I glad to be getting out of that floating death trap.
Oh, these horses look fresher! Woo! Hey!
and healthy.
Before you degrade these poor fools any further, tell me where I'm headed.
Of course, of course. Let me think.
You do know people down here, aside from your friends who welcomed us on the way.
Yes, I think so. I was real drunk last time I was here, John. You know how it is. I met an American guy, saw him shoot a man, drank with him in the village of Chuparosa. Funny guy. Or was that Canada? No, that was Canada. Guy here, not funny, but he's real nice. Failing that, you could try the provincial governor, Colonel something or other. Some Spanish name. He's based out of Escalera. I played three-card stud with him. Or was it four-card Monty? I forget. He was a real nice chap. Or maybe he was a real bastard. I was real drunk last time, John.
Well, thanks a lot for your help. Oh, let me guess. You gotta be on your way.
The famed hospitality isn't what it once was, and I've never been known to overstay me welcome. So off I go to greener pastures. Good luck, John. You're an angry and a feck ugly man, but not a bad one.